It's supposed to be dry tonight. It's supposed to be quite warm tonight. So, for the first time in 2023, I've put the moth trap out. There's something that's expected to drain. This wasn't forecast, but the moth trap's been out, and look, can you see down there? There's at least one moth. I don't have to check on the inside. Hopefully there'll be more on the inside, but at least I know I've got at least one moth. I'm in my workshop, got the moth trap here, and also my tubs. I don't expect to fill all of these at this time of year. Although later in the year, I'll be doing this and a lot more, filling all these and a lot more. This one here that's upside down, that's the one with the moth in it. If it's got a moth in it, it's turned upside down. That way, you never forget that you've got a moth in one of these and leave it and forget to release. Moth traps here. It's a bit damp, but that's okay because this funnel here, any water that goes down here, it then goes down into a further funnel, which like you can see down in there, and it goes out a hole in the bottom. So moths go in, hit the light, they hit the light, drop down, and hopefully, if they've been in, they're behind one of these cartons. So let's go and have a look. Nothing. Oh dear. This happens. It's quite early in the season. Did get one on the outside, and you know, it's just sort of, you know, this time of year you don't get a lot of moths on the wing. I would only be looking at sort of, you know, if I got up into high single figures, that would be a really big capture for me at this time of year. So that's a shame. But let's go and ID this one. That was moth thing is you forget from year to year. Well, I forget from year to year. It's not everyone. Some people can remember these names forever once they've learned them. I have to learn them all over again. I recognise that moth, but I can't remember what its name is. So I'm going to have to get the book out. This little one here is a pale brindle beauty. So, interestingly, I know it's a male. The reason I know it's a male, it's got wings. The females don't have wings. They just sit around and exude pheromones to attract the males in to mate. So, this one is a pale brindled beauty. Now, if you can afford a nice big moth book like this, this one's about 20 odd quid, I think. What you can do is use an app that's called the What's Flying Tonight app. From Butterfly Conservation, really good, and it doesn't give you all the moths, but it uses your geographical location and your date off the phone to actually identify what moths have been recorded flying in your area around that time. So it's really good. So let's go and see where the pale brindle beauty is in my area. Wow, it's actually number one, 5 records. Another thing you can do to help with ID, although this is not ideal because it can be a bit sort of like hit and miss, is use an online photographic identification app such as Seek or Google Lens. Works sometimes, other times the results can be a bit iffy. But let's see what this one, what if Seek is able to identify this, and see what Google Lens says as well. And here's Seek. And Google Lens. So Seek was spot on. Google Lens, not quite as accurate, but would have got you there in the end if you'd done some research. However, I'm going to stick to my book. And here's a close-up. You can see those feathery antenna, and that's what he'll use to find his mate. Gorgeous. So I'm going to stick this little chap somewhere cool for the day and then release him this evening.